Hello everyone, welcome again to another one of my video channels. My name is Ed Walker and I will be your host for Surfing the Net Computer Repair. In this video we're going to replace an HP internal keyboard. The older traditional keyboards were replaced from the top by 1 to 3 screws in the back. Pull it out from the top, undo the ribbon cable, throw it aside, pop another one in it, 3 screws, and you're done. A little different with the internal keyboard. They claim that you're not to replace the keyboard itself, but rather the whole palm rest, the top of the computer, which holds the laptop. But you can actually replace that keyboard in the palm rest. You just have to remove everything, the motherboard and all the devices and so forth. We're going to show how to do that in this video. So let's get started. Okay, here we have an HP. And this is an HP 15CW1095NR. And as you can see, it needs a keyboard. Okay. So let's go ahead and replace this keyboard. Since it has to be all disassembled from the bottom. That will have holes up here when the keyboard's done. I'm going to put a safety thing to protect the screen while we do this. And we'll flip it over. And we'll go ahead and disassemble. Over the other side. So we don't lose that. We'll just go around this.
It's had some damage done to it. A few drops, but the ends are a little bit bad. Got this off. Again, got to remove the battery. All this to get to the let's go ahead and remove the battery. Ribbon cable for the touchpad. Ribbon cable for the keyboard. It's out. And we also have a ribbon cable for an SD card reader. This right here is the hard drive, which is an M.2. We'll remove that. Down to the board, we're gonna take out the memory, which is an 8 gigabyte stick. One, take that out. Okay, now we're gonna get. Okay, let's turn this around. Next, we're going to remove the fan. Screw should do it. Battery's running low on the little handrail, so we'll just do our parts here. Fan. Go ahead and remove some more cables. This here is, we're gonna remove cable. Go ahead and remove this card reader board. And I'll remove this speaker. And we got to remove the hinge. Okay. Now this wire for the speakers is out of there. This is the DC jack. I'm gonna go ahead and move it off the speaker. All right. Let's move this other hinge. That hinge is removed. So let's loosen up. All kinds of room on the speaker, huh? Cable. We'll just go ahead and remove the video cable here. Get that out of the way. We should. Yeah, we gotta start the motherboard here first. File it right on around. up at an angle. That is the motherboard. And that is the heat sink for the processor. Go ahead and set that to the side. And now we're going to remove this USB port board. As you can see, this is the back plate of your keyboard. Yeah, I'll leave it to them to come up with some deal like this. But this is the plate for your keyboard, and we're going to remove that. Let me remove this. The speaker wire here. There's our speakers. Okay. Okay. I just laid the board down. Let's see. These studs. Okay. Got to secure this board in. See, normally these were designed not to replace the keyboard, but to actually replace this whole palm rest with the keyboard already attached. But we're going to go ahead and put the keyboard in. Couple of these studs. Now I have in the past I have used a soldering gun and a plastic tie, and with a heat gun, I heated a little bit of the plastic tie to make my plastic stud. But I managed to save most of the studs that are in the board. There's another one. That one's broke, so I don't need a stud there. Ever so gently, okay. This is not a lighted keyboard, but I get this just for the extra padding to put between the keyboard and the back shield. So I don't need the ribbon cable for the backlight, because it doesn't have a backlight designed on this board. Okay, and I've cleaned out the speaker screens. Installed. Really don't want any type of gap. On this. Normally I would put a little plastic or glue speakers. Okay. Looks to be complete. Now, time to check it out. Thank you. So you don't have Microsoft Office on here, so let's go into PowerShell. And we'll try 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0. That's good. QWR. Yep. Like all the keys work. Try caps. Yep. Keyboard's installed and ready to.
And that will conclude the video on replacing the HP internal keyboard. I hope that you pick something up from this and it makes it easier if you should ever have to install one of them keyboards internally. Also, if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. Or if you do not like the video, give me a thumbs down. Give a comment of why. And if you'd like to see more of these videos for my repair shop, just give a subscribe, hit the subscribe button. And also, if you want to be notified of our upcoming videos, click on the little bell icon and you'll be notified of our upcoming video. Again, thanks for watching. Happy surfing.